Cosmos Kwame Akorli, me program manager of Penplusbytes. Penplusbytes, me sure say do don't know when you anti Penplusbytes in
kind. Penplusbytes,
no, to say we could be a own share about it. I bet me I can say civil society group. But the Juma for Tia Jenny said, we do training, Yama citizen in Tia Power, oil and gas extractive, your governance and technology, sir, never EID technology. And I say, young phones are kita social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, you know, then you be boa, send your be ya. Citizens who take interest in governance issues in the, wherever they live. Yes, our new media, no. They yet training my journalist.
Okay.
So nearby, you to me, Ayomujuma here or oil and gas and other areas of interest to citizens. Okay. And see, my bad district move it Monday. Mini assembly for the Ellembelle district assembly for you. You share that you didn't get a home. You did project beer by your friend, no. Tech driven social accountability for results project. I supported by Osiwa. Na umubwa project no. Nti nititi yao ni se. Yepesi yefa technology so. Social media, WhatsApp, Facebook, any other tools are yao to promote good governance. Nti the project is going to focus on the poverty reduction strategies that we have in Ellembelle district. We are talking about school feeding, livelihood empowerment against poverty, labor intensive public works, among others. So I've already been to some of the beneficiary schools under the school feeding. I've also been to the GSOP side, that's the labor intensive public works side this morning. We are going to focus on monitoring, working in collaboration with the assembly. We are not the hey chubu chubu type. We just collaborate with the assembly and train citizens to take interest in whatever is going on and feedback to the assembly, engage on the difficulty, the challenges that they come across in these interventions. It is not for nothing that Ellembelle until recently was the only district in the Western region benefiting from, let's say, the GSOP project, for instance.
Okay.
So it means that we have issues that must be addressed. The district is a host to the refugees, a lot of refugees here. We have social issues and we need to support the district. I believe that if you promote this project, we mobilize citizens to take interest in these social interventions, the school feeding, the livelihood and empowerment against poverty and the rest. We'll be empowering the citizens to work effectively with the assemblies to increase the revenue base of the assembly and all that. So that the assembly is empowered. We will be leaving, by the time we leave the district, we would have left a very critical mass of citizens who will be able to engage to promote accountability, participate effectively in the district's work. And this largely is the objective of the project. We've already created a website for the project.
Okay.
The places I have been to, it's not every citizen that can get up and go to a school. The livelihood empowerment against poverty, the communities are very far. It will not take any ordinary citizen to go there. A citizen with courage will be able to go there. So what does it mean? It means that when we mobilize them, empower them, today the mobile phone penetration in Ghana is, we have more mobile phones than citizens in this country. It means that we should take advantage of these tools to do what we call citizen journalism, for instance, to be able to bring out the issues wherever they are, so that even if not everybody can go to such communities, because they are very far away, few can do the job for us. And the website, for instance, the address will be shared with everybody. You get there, you see every project site, what is going on. Currently, what I have done since I came to the district is to gather a baseline data for the project, so we know where we are. The livelihood empowerment project, I've gathered the data for the labor intensive public works. So it means that as we go along, we'll see what increment we are getting, what progress we are making against the baseline data that I've gathered so far. Largely, this is the focus of the project. And we must, I am very grateful, Penplusbytes is very grateful, OCY is very grateful to the assembly for their warm reception so far. Citizens are very fantastic here, and we believe that with that spirit, we can be very effective in this work. We can be very effective in ensuring that the issues that will arise from school feeding, we can engage collectively on it, raise the issues, government, the various stakeholders will be able to address them, because we have to help communities, citizens, those who cannot afford to cater for their children at school. We are providing these services so that they can be in school. So if there are issues, we should address them. LEAP is also meant for a reason. We want to offer, give these people who are struggling some money to be able to fend for themselves, to take their children to school, also to be able to register for NHIS. As part of that package, we should be able to bring out the issues and address them. That goes for the rest of the social intervention or poverty reduction strategies that we have. And I believe that with you, West End Radio, with the Additional Assembly collaborating, and citizens that we'll be working with, will have a very fruitful working relationship in the assembly, so that by the time we leave the district, we would have left a very critical mass of citizens who will be able to engage with the assembly, support the assembly in its work to further raise the standard of the district. This is my mission. Thank you very much.
For how long is this project going to take?
The project is running for 2 years.
2 years?
Yes. But one thing I can assure you is this. We earlier implemented one OCY project, that is connecting citizens to parliament.
Okay.
The purpose of that project was to simply follow up with all the government assurances made on the floor of parliament. I am telling you that because of the success of that project, OCY came back to us with this support again. So what it means is that if we are very effective in this work, by the time the project ends, OCY will further support that. I must also assure you that the work that we'll be doing, there will be other stakeholders. The World Bank is supporting school feeding. They are supporting various interventions, and they are interested. They may support us, they may support other groups who come to the district. Other groups, other donors, other international, the international committee is very interested.
Okay.
So somebody may come to the district, even without our knowledge, to come and support the district, just by the virtue of the work we have done, or we'll be doing, because we are going to promote the district using our technology tools, and people will get to know more about the district.
Mm-hmm.
That is what is going to happen.
Mr. Akorli, thanks having you at the studios of Western. I think we're going to have a very fruitful and good working relationship as you stay here to do this project.
Thank you very much. I'm also very grateful.
Mr. Cosmos A. Akorli is a